Here's a completely different notion of survival. But again, chemistry plays its part.
All the people on the ground are sick and tired of hearing astronauts say, "Wow, this is great." So we had said, "We're not going to do that." But I had to bite my tongue because I just wanted to say something that would express how it felt to me to be out there and to have that view. But we opened the hatch and we went outside, and it was like, okay, before this hand lets go, I'm going to make sure this hand's got a good grip. Sort of the deep fear that you're just going to go drifting off, you know, and even though the orbiter pilot can fly after you and pick you up and all that stuff, again, your sort of deep instincts don't think about that.
To put that man out in this hostile environment for hours on end is a technical tour de force, which involves a lot of chemistry. And the suit the astronauts wear is the place it can be seen.
First inside layer of the suit is what we call the cooling garment. And that is a pair of long johns that the astronaut wears. It has a series of tubes running through it that we circulate water to keep the astronaut cool. The next layer that in the suit itself is the inside bladder. And this provides the pressure protection for the astronaut to keep the pressure and the oxygen within the suit so they can breathe it. Now we've got the next layer is what we call the restraint, and what that does, it retains the bladder from blowing up into a balloon when it's pressurized.
Those inner layers contain the astronaut's own little atmosphere. They have to be airtight. The synthetic materials prevent leakage of gases. And this means that the carbon dioxide, which we breathe out, increases in concentration in there. If you did nothing about it, it would build up to a toxic level. The answer is in a relatively simple bit of chemistry.
Lithium hydroxide was selected because it's so light. That's one of the big drivers in space business, is to get things light, because we got to launch them up into orbit and that costs fuel. What it does is it takes CO2 molecules and they react with the lithium hydroxide molecules. And that reaction works pretty well. But you have to add a little water to it to make it work really well. And just so happens in the suit, the crewman puts off water as sweat and perspiration. So that's perfect for our environment. So that reaction works very well, and we can get several hours out of our little canister.
A demonstration shows the straightforward reaction. We didn't have an astronaut handy, so we got the CO2 from dry ice, solid carbon dioxide. Bubble this through a solution of lithium hydroxide, and you produce lithium carbonate, the white solid that is making the liquid look milky.
The disadvantage with lithium hydroxide is it's not a reversible reaction. Once we take the CO2 and react it with the lithium hydroxide, we get lithium carbonate. And for our purposes, we have to throw that away. And there are other ways to remove CO2 that is regenerable, so we can turn that reaction around. But they're much heavier, and for our purposes, didn't trade well.
Next layer we have is the inside liner of the outside thermal garment. And what that does, it provides some structural integrity for the suit. As the astronaut's doing various works, it just provides a structural layer for the suit. Next layers are five layers of what we call aluminized mylar. And what this does, it provides protection for the astronaut and allows the heat within the suit to be retained inside the suit without it leaking out into a space vacuum. The material that's used in constructing this outer layer is Kevlar, and it's used in protection from micrometeoroids and also reflects the sun's rays as the astronaut's doing work.
The outside of the suit must be tough. What they do is physical work around sharp objects. It's a bit like being on a construction site. What you don't want is a tear or puncture. And Kevlar is the best material for the job. 6 times stronger than spun steel. It'll stop a bullet.
I feel really safe in the suit. And maybe even I'm a little naive, maybe I feel safer than I should. You just feel like you can do anything you need to do. It'd take longer, but you can do it, you can get there.
The cost of a spacesuit, if you were to go buy one at Sears and Roebuck, would be about $10 million.
Thank you.